Welcome to EPG Padasala. I am Dr. K. Mavalirajan from Department of Ancient Indian History, Culture and Archaeology, Vishwabharati University, Shantiniketan. The subject Indian Culture, the paper Socio and Cultural History of India from Earliest to 1707 AD. The paper Socio and Cultural Life during the Sangam Age. When we introduce the Sangam Age, the Sangam period was from 3rd century BC to the 3rd century AD. During this period, three powerful monarchs were ruled in South India. They were the Cheras and Cholas and Pandyas. During these three dynasties, many changes took place in the field of society, in the field of education, in the field of religion, in the field of cultural aspect. There we can find many number of sources, mostly literary sources, speaks about the socio and cultural life of the Sangam Age. The learning objectives of the Prussian modules are to know about the social practices of the Sangam Age, to understand the cultural value of the Sangam period, to know about the Thinai concept and its socio and cultural aspect, to understand the social structure of the Sangam Age, the practice and prevalence of the slavery, custom and practices, religious idea and practices, finally to understand about the education and fine arts of the Sangam Age. In introduction part, the Sangam Age witnessed the rapid development in the field of literary works. The great poet, writers and other literary personalities of the Sangam Age have left behind invaluable accounts of political, social, cultural life of the people. Literary sources provide information regarding the classification of the land and its people, caste system and various occupations, practice of slavery, dress and food habits of the people, status of women, religious practice, education and fine arts. So in that socio and cultural aspect of the Sangam period, we can find the many changes in the socio and cultural life of the people. Now we discuss about the important sources which help us to understand the socio and cultural life of the Sangam Age. The literature are the primary sources for understanding the cultural and social life of the people. The Sangam literature consists of the early Tamil grammars works such as Tolhapiyam and Ettuthogai and Pattupattu and Padinan Keelkanak works and five epics Silapadiharam, Manimehalai, Kundalahesi, Valayapathi and Sivaga Sindamani. The post-Sangam literature, Thirukkural, also important literary works to understand the socio and cultural life of the people of post-Sangam period. In the social life of the Sangam Age, the Thinai concept is important. The whole South Indian territory of the Sangam period was divided into five physiographical division, which known as Thinai. The Thinai was divided into five, which known as the five Thinais or Aindhinais. The early Tamil text convey a vivid idea about five types of ecological and cultural zone of the Sangam Age, namely Kurunji, Mullai, Marudam, Neidal and Palai, which is referred to as Aindhinai or Five Thinai in Tamil literature. Each Thinai had its own distinct occupational pattern, and corresponding forms of worship, customs, and manners. The five Tinais also reflect the geographical and social division of the people. It denotes the distinguished mode of behaviors, social and moral life of the people of each physiographical regions. In the five Tinai, the Kurunji region is most important in the social life of the people. The mountain and its surrounding is known as Kurunji, was famous for slash and burn cultivation. The Kuravar and Kanwar are mentioned as the inhabitants of the Kurunji land. Hunting, sifting cultivation, collecting honey from the trees were referred to as their main occupations. The women folk of the Kurunji regions were Kurathi and Kuramakkal. They generally lived in and around the hills in small settlement. They worshipped mostly Murugan as their prime deity. Next, the Mullai region. The forest and pastoral tracts called as Mullai region, which were pasture, meadows and scrublands, where sifting cultivation and animal husbandry were found in Mullai region. The pastoral groups referred to in literature as Ayar, Idayar and Kovalar. The Idayar of Mullai region is most cases referred to the shepherd who had flock of goats. These tracts were region of expanding the agricultural activities, and we find slow transition from a pastoral to agrarian economy. There also we find a kind of the transition from the cultivation pattern, the traditional cultivation pattern, to the modern cultivation system. Both Kurunji and Mullai regions had cultivable slopes where sifting cultivation or slash and burn cultivation were found. Their main deity was Thirumal or Mayun in Kurunji region. Next, we discuss about the Marudam region, which is very fertile land during the Sangam period. Marudam region were the fertile agricultural tracts of the Sangam period. The inhabitants of the Marudam regions were called Ulavar and Tholuvar. They were those who plowed, sowed, transplanted and harvested the agricultural product. The fertile of the land, agricultural process and irrigation facilities in Marudam regions are vividly portrayed in the early Sangam literature. They cultivated variety of agricultural product like paddy, sugarcane, mango, plantain, jack and other fruit trees. The people of region used to drink the juice of the sugarcane. The main deity was Indra, the rain god of the early Tamil society. Next, the two more divisions, the Neidal and Palay region, also the important geographical regions during the Sangam age. The Neidal was the coastal region. Fishing was the natural occupation of the Neidal land. The Paradavar, Valainyar were inhabitants of the littoral tract of the Neidal regions. The other social group of Neidal tract were the Womaner. Mostly they were the manufacturer of salt as well as the traders of the salt product. The people of Neidal took pork and liquor. The god of the regions was Varuna, the god of rain. The Palay was a sandy and dry regions. There the Maravar and other community were the inhabitants of the Palay regions. Martial groups like Maravar, Malavar, Yainar were the inhabitants of the Palay. The Maravar or Malavar performed different activities like robbing, fighting, and killing wayfarers who passed through their tracks, fighting for sheep and lifting cattle or recovering stolen cattle. Another martial groups mentioned in the early text is the Mallar. They are the warriors with immense strength who fight bravely against the stranger. They worshipped the goddesses Kotravai or Kali. These both the deities were the prime deity of the Palai region. In the Dinai concept, five geographical divisions, Kurunji, Mullai, Marudam, Neidal and Palai, played vital role in the social formation as well as the cultural development of the Sangam age. Now we discuss about the caste system as well as the fourfold social division of the Sangam age. The Varna-based society is not clearly mentioned in the Tamil regions. The earliest Tamil grammar work, Tolkapiyam, speaks about the four Varna concept. The Tolkapiyam, oldest Tamil grammar work of the Sangam age, in a section speaks of fourfold division of society, namely Andanar, Arasar, Vanihar and Velalar. The Andanars were Brahmin, the Arasar were the royal kings, Vanihar were the Vaisyas and Velalar were mostly agricultural community. It was influenced by the northern Brahmanical idea of Sadhuvarna system and tried to apply the concept into the Tamilakam through the little difference. The fourfold division referred to in Tolkapiyam seems to have been an occupational division like the Sadhuvarna system. Mostly, the Brahmins of the early Tamil society, they involved in the teaching, studying the Vedas and other religious scripture. The Arasar mostly involved in the administrative activities. The Vanihar, the third category, they are the mostly the commercial communities. They actively involved in the trade and the commercial activities of the inland trade. The Velalar are the agricultural community. They mostly equated with the Sudra Varna of the four Varna system. The Velalas of the Tamil country were not the Sudras of northern India, although they are mentioned as the fourth category. We can also find references to a division between Uyandur and the Kilur. The Uyandur is considered as the higher one and Kilur is considered as the lower one. The idea of twice born is used only for the Brahmins who are referred to by the term Irupurapalan. Some of the community were considered as the Ilipurapalan because they born as the low caste. The Ilipurapalan mostly treated as the untouchable, but Irupurapalar considered as the highest Varna in the social division of the South India. Besides, there are quite number of the references in the early Tamil text about the references to the Irupurapalan, which is low-born. Mostly the Brahmas, Thudiyan and Parayan were considered as the low caste. The Pulaya was also considered low-born in the social life. In account of their menial work, mostly they involved in the menial service of the society. In the social division of the early Sangam society, the mostly we find four division of the social system. The Andanar, Arasar, Vanihar and Velalar, they occupied important position in the social life of the Sangam age. Now we discuss about the practice of slavery in early Tamil society. Slavery was a social evil found at different times in most part of the world. The practice of slavery did exist in Tamilakam and pre-Pallava period, which is most popular social institution in the social life of the Tamil people. The available sources, though scanty, but clearly point out the existence of slavery in early Tamil society. As a part of patriarchal system, the slaves performed services in menial or semi-menial capacities. Mostly they involved in the unclean work like the funeral ceremony. They mostly involved in the agricultural practices and the slave in the agrarian land of the landlords. In division of the slaves of the early Tamil society, we find two kinds of the slaves. One is agrarian slaves and domestic slaves. The agrarian slaves mostly involved in the agricultural activities. The domestic slaves mostly involved in the domestic works of their landowners. Now we concentrate on the position of women during the Sangam period. The women in early Tamilakam seems to have performed different role in a society. They mostly involved in production process as housewives and poetess. As a singer and dancers, they played vital role in the social life of the people. Mostly the role of women was subordinate and dependent on the economic life of the people. As a mother, daughter and wife, they played vital role in the family life as well as the social life of human society. There was no statement of legal and social equality between the sexes in the Sangam age. We can understand clearly that the duties of women in society are different from those of the men. The Tolhapiyar says that while it is desirable that is an ideal marriage, men and women shall be equal to each other in beauty and attainments, wealth, manner and etc. Mostly in the social life of the women of the early Tamil society, mostly the men and women were equally treated. Mostly the men and women involved in the social activities as well as the religious practices. The women were also expert in various fine arts. They were equally challengeable with men folk of the early Tamil society. They were given training in literature, music and drama. The Sangam works bear evidences to fact that many women had distinguished themselves in the art of music. The education received by women was different from that imparted to men. More than 50 women have been ranked among the Sangam poets who were well versed in the literary field. Mostly, Kakai Padiniyar has contributed two works on prosody, namely Kakai Padiniyam and Siru Kakai Padiniyam. These are the few examples of the women scholars they well versed in the literary tradition of early Tamil society. The women of the warrior community mentioned in Purananuru as Mudin Magalir. We find interesting evidences in Purananuru regarding the extraordinary bravery activity of the Sangam women. A brave misfortune lady, even after the loss of her brother and husband, sent her only son with the spear to fight the enemies. These are the few examples of the brave women of the early Sangam society. Women have been glorified in Tamil literature as the lamp of home. Women always had spoken of long with her chastity and moral life of the early Tamil society. They played a vital role in the social life. Mostly the women equally participated in the social life and the religious life of the Sangam period. In the women folk of the Sangam society, we find a distinguished women in the social life of the early Tamils were Parathayar. The Sangam literature noticed unholy practice of concubinage. The anthologies on love like Ahananuru, Purananuru and Natchinai reveal that in actual practice of the Parathayar system. There were two principal categories of the Parathayar. The first one is Cheri Parathai and another one is Kadal Parathai. The Cheri Parathai appear have been a public harlot, while the Kadal Parathai led a virtuous life. Mostly the Cheri Parathai and Kadal Parathai lived in a separate place. Mostly they attracted the men folk of the villages and the important places. Of the two classes of the Parathayar community, the Kadal Parathai occupied a higher social status than the Cheri Parathai. The Cheri Parathai were described as Vilai Nala Pendir and Podu Maghlir. Ilam Puranar, the commentator of Tolkapiyam, speaks of a class described as Kamaklathiyar, the Parathayas for sexual pleasure. The Parathayas were generally skilled in music and dance. Now we discuss about custom and practices of Sangam age. Family was the basic unit of early society. Several families constituted a village which is known as Oor. The picture of the village varied according to the physiographical division as occupation varied. Yet, in all the villages, there were common social behavior and practices. They had uniform festivals and pastimes. Hospitality was a welcome social practice which was very famous in early Tamil society. Guests were entertained, relatives were treated as the members of the family, they were welcomed and entertained well with the smiling face in the entire South Indian society. Mostly these the custom still also which is in practice. In the custom and practices, housewarming, purification ceremony, bapar tea and marriage ceremonies were popular in the family life of the people. There are many festivals were famous, particularly the Onam, Kartikai, Pongal, Panguni Vilavu were popular celebration and festival during the Sangam age. In festival occasion, the village elders and learned person were given respective status. Every ceremony was presided by lighting the lamp called Vilakettal in Tamil tradition. Now food habits. Rice was the staple food of the Tamils. There are several references to the use of other grains like maize and millet. The people of Kurunji region mostly ate cooked millet. Pulses like kollu, kadalai and velai also found mention in early Tamil literature. The hunters of Kurunji region frequently helped themselves to meat obtained through their hunt. The people also consumed a variety of fishes. The Paradavar took cooked rice mixed with a soup of aile fish. These are the some of the food habits of the five geographical division of the Sangam age. Apart from these paddy and grains of the others, The milk products also formed an important item of the dietary of Afghans and the shepherds of the Mulai region. Various vegetables were used: mangoes, jackfruits, bananas, coconuts, and other delicious fruits were taken with mixed honey, milk, and sugar. Nellikani was also popular fruits of the early Sangam period. The novel polymera fruit, gooseberry, and the rip tamarind were also popular during the Sangam age. The people of Sangam age used different kind of dress materials. Barks of trees, plaited leaves, as well as cotton and silk clothes were used. Generally, men wore two clothes of cotton, one around the waist and the other the upper cloth thrown over shoulders. There are many references in the Sangam classics to the Kalingam cloth. Rich ladies wore Kalingam, which was a famous variety of fine cotton fabric. Silk too is found mentioned in several places of the Sangam literature. Apart from the various kind of the ornaments, the people of Sangam age also used different ornaments. The Tamils wore different ornaments. Mostly the ornaments were made of gold, silver, precious stone, and pearls. Girls and women had craze for ornaments. There are several references in early Sangam literature for the different names of the ornaments which used by the Sangam people. All the married women wear thali, which was the symbol of marriage. Malai they wore on neck. Thodi was the armlet. They used bracelet, and mehlai was the waist ornament. Anklet was called silambu. It was the important ornament for Nupil girls. Now we come to education system. There was a lofty conception of education from the early times. The term kalvi more or less corresponded to the connotation of word education. The large body of poems produced by nearly 500 poets and scholars belonging to different classes of people during the Sangam age, which indicate that education must have had fairly wide popularity in the Sangam age. Upper society like the king, the priest, merchant, but even the peasants, Kuravas, Maravar, and the other community, they had chance to learn education from the educational institution. Thiruvalluvar laid special emphasis on the value of education in one of his chapters in Thirukkural. When we consider the women educations, we find several references in the early Sangam literatures of various women scholars. There were many women literary personality in early Tamil society, mostly Avvayar, Nachellayar, Kakaipadiniyar were the popular women poetess contributed much for the development of Tamil literature. Among the women, Perungopindu Parimagalir was poetess of extraordinary merit. Women from the hunter, watcher, and potter classes were also learned education in educational institution. Kakaipadiniyar composed an excellent work on prosody. It is to be pointed out that education was common for all, men and women, rich and poor, kings and commoner, high and low born. The poets played a very prominent role in the social life of the people. We can find the several instances of the women poets as well as the men poets, they contributed much for the promotion of art and literature in the Sangam period. In the religious aspect, the Sangam period also witnessed for the development of the religious idea in the cultural life of the people. Sangam literature present religious concept and practices of different stages of early Tamils. The primitive religious idea and practices, pre-Aryan ideas, Aryan elements and thoughts and notions of new religions are embedded in the Sangam classics. The practice of worshipping the dead and the ancestor which was popular in the Sangam period. This practice came from the belief that the spirit lives even after death. They had also practice of erecting hero stone and memorial stone in early days of the Sangam society. The early Tamil work Tolhapiyam provide the names of the deities and methods of worship in the physiographical units Kurunji, Mullai, Marudam, Neidal and Palai. Accordingly, Seyon was the main god of Kurunji land, Mayon the main god of the Mullai land, Vendan the main god of the Marudam, Varuna in Neidal land and Kotravai in Palai land. Apart from the five division of the main gods, the people of Sangam also worship the different other gods like the mother worship and the ancestor worship in the social life of the people. The early Tamil people performed different rituals and sacrifices. The worship of mother goddesses was also in practice, which was in different forms. The Kotravai worship was a very ancient form of worship of mother goddesses. Brahmanism became to make its inroad in the South India, with kings performing Vedic sacrifices and higher classes adopting worship of Vedic gods. Buddhism and Jainism also began to spreading, though Brahmanism occupied the important place in the higher class of society. At the same time, worship of various indigenous gods continued among the common people and the tribes of the Sangam society. So, the religious practice was common. On the basis of different geographical unit, the people of Sangam age worshipped different gods and goddesses. Now we discuss about fine arts of the Sangam age. Various fine arts were very popular in Sangam age. Poetry, music, dancing were very popular. The poets were men and women drawn from all classes of society. Music and dancing were highly developed and popular. Musical instruments of various types are described and included many kinds of yal and variety of drums in the early Tamil society. Viralis sometimes danced at night by torchlight, and particular dance poses of the hands are mentioned by name as in the Natya Shastra of Parada. In summary, the age of Sangam in the extreme South India was one of the cultural transformation. The three dynasties, the Cheras and Cholas and Pandyas, played a vital role in the development of the culture and society. The literature gave vivid picture on the socio and cultural life of the people. For Tamils, the Sangam age was the period of evolution from total chieftains to kingdom. The society and culture of the Sangam age was very much important in the South Indian history. We can find in the social life of the people different occupational groups, different social divisions, different worship pattern, different way of life, different food habits and different cultural background we get it from the literary sources. Mostly the Sangam literature provide the valuable information on the socio and cultural life of the people, which is the one of the most finest literary tradition in South India. It contains mostly the secular tradition as well as the religious tradition of South India. Thank you very much for watching the video. For further information, you can visit EPJ Padasala website.